I believe that, you know, the pornography, the breaking down of the family is all essentially of Jewish origins at this point. And somehow everyone seems to be a child of that indoctrination, you know? It's as if there's no traditional values left.
Well, that's the point of pornography. The point of pornography, the point of these sexual revolutions is to break down traditional moral values, because morality is your only defense against the rich and the powerful. This is the really insidious nature of this sexual revolution, is that it actually gets inside you, and you actually start to defend your own oppressors because you claim it's freedom, because you want to do what you want to do. And you don't understand that you're only free to do what is right, not to do what you want, no matter what that is. And if you break away from just doing what is right, you're going to end up being enslaved by the people who control the environment. And that's what happened.
This is an excellent point by E. Michael Jones. Our only protection from the rich and powerful, he says, is morality. So Srila Prabhupada is bringing the real standard of morality and what is right. The more we do what we want, what we feel, is we've been indoctrinated by the Jews to feel, with this sexual liberation movement, to feel that we can do what we want, be free, and we can be free to do whatever we feel. But that's nonsense. We have to do what is right. So what is right? Most people don't even know what is right. Well, that problem is solved by the Lord sent his representative, Srila Prabhupada, his Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, and he is showing us what is right and what is moral. What is moral? Well, there's four basic principles. Prabhupada summed up morality in four principles. No illicit sex. That means sex only for procreation with one's married wife. No intoxication, including tea and coffee. No meat, fish or egg eating. And no gambling. These are the four pillars. Just like any table or something, a table is held up by four pillars, four legs. So these are the four legs of sinful life. So if we take to if we follow these moral principles and avoid sinful life, that is our strength, that is our protection against the ruling elite, the ruling dogs. They're not elites, they're dogs, they're demons. So this is our protection against them. This is our strength. We have to know that purity is our strength. Morality is our strength. Doing right is our strength. Being a liberal and doing whatever we want. We're not doing whatever we want. We're being used by the Jew world order. The Jews are using us. They're making us, they've pumped into our civilizations the idea of freedom and liberty. They've only done that to degrade us and make us lose our powers. Our power lies in our morality, in our purity. And Srila Prabhupada, Adolf Hitler checked the spread of the Jews' Bolshevik revolution. That was a war on the physical plane, and Adolf Hitler was empowered by the Lord to check the spread of that. For what purpose? For the purpose that Srila Prabhupada could come to fertile soils, America and Europe. I've discussed this in my other videos. The point I'm trying to get at is that the war, the demons' war on our civilizations, went from a physical war to a war of subversion, a war of subversion on the moral fiber of our previously Christian civilizations. Our civilizations had morality before. It had morality based on Christianity, the morals that Jesus Christ and other pure devotees like Srila Prabhupada had instilled. And those were remaining on some level, some small level in our civilization. So the Jews have attacked with their cultural Marxist revolution. Their agenda is clear. They're attacking the moral fiber of our civilizations and making us believe that to do the right thing, to be moral, is some type of suppression, that we have to be liberated and do what we want. This is a trick. Understand it. It's a trick to weaken us. And we're so weak and so fallen that now people don't even know what they are. People are thinking, oh, I was born a man, but I feel like a woman, or I have attraction to the opposite sex, homosexuality, transgender. People are so confused in the name of being liberated. They're liberated for going to hell, Prabhupada said. The path is righteousness. To know what is right and to do right and to be moral, that is our strength. And that is the way that, as E. Michael Jones very nicely points out, that is our protection from the rich and powerful. The demons, in other words. He called them rich and powerful. Let's just call them what they are. They're demons, rakshasas, man-eaters. That's what they do. They're into man-eating. They sacrifice little children. They rape little children. And then they kill them and eat them and drink the blood. Rakshasas, Prabhupada said in the Bhagavatam. The Bhagavatam predicted in these times, in Kali Yuga, that the ruling classes would be rakshasas, man-eaters. Read the Srimad Bhagavatam. It's there. The rulers would be rakshasas, man-eaters. So how do we become protected from these rakshasas? Through morality, by being moral, by being righteous. This is our strength. They cannot defeat us if we are moral and righteous. And Srila Prabhupada has been sent by the Lord to counteract this cultural Marxist revolution and give us real morality. But we cannot follow this morality, these moral principles. No illicit sex, no intoxication, no eating of meat, fish and egg, and no gambling. We cannot follow these without having the association of the Lord, having the strength from the Lord. The Lord is present in his holy name, the holy name of the Lord, and the Lord himself is none different. So when we chant the holy name, we directly associate with the Lord. When we hear from Srila Prabhupada, Prabhupada is transcendental on the level of the Lord. When we hear from Prabhupada, we associate with Prabhupada. And this is where we get our strength. And when we get our strength from the Lord and the pure devotee of the Lord, Srila Prabhupada, then we have morality and righteousness. And then the Jews cannot defeat us.